What's up, everybody? This is Be Your Boy Scotty, and this is Bitch Are You Serious number 12.5. This is pretty much a follow-up to Bitch Are You Serious number 12 when I was talking about the incident with Molly the Maid at my job. I'm doing this video with a headache, and I'm exhausted. I've been off of work for like almost like an hour and 30 minutes. I was trying to call a certain somebody, but I think they're asleep. But I'm sure I'll talk to them later. But let's see. This is me basically following up to what happened before. So I'm going to let you know what happened with me and Molly the Maid since the issue happened. I've seen her on several occasions since I did the video and since we had the altercation at the store. And I'm just going to let you know about a lot of things that have happened. And I want y'all to leave y'all comments like y'all did last time. So let's just get into it, shall we? So, you know, I would say, like, I did the video, like, I think a few days after the incident. So, I would say that a few days after I did the video, rather, which marked, like, a whole week after the situation, she came in Dollar General Market, which is where I work, and it was, like, 30 more minutes left for me to be on the clock, meaning I had to close that night. So, that meant I was the only cashier there, and I had my manager, and I had, the front end stocker there. So it was like three of us working that night. She comes in, and from the moment she comes in, she sees me on register two, and she speaks. Hey, Scotty. I don't say nothing. She goes over for strawberries, and then she asks for some ice, and I had to get up and get the ice for her. And it was like she was doing everything she could to get a reaction. Like, she constantly speaking over and over and over again. And when I won't make the bitch relevant, she wants to say, well, Scotty, I was just joking, but you take things too seriously. Bitch, are you serious? Number one, you don't know me like that. Number two, I don't like you. And number three, you don't like me. And number four, bitch, you are not just joking with me. Like, all this, look if you buck and I'm a grown-ass woman and all this shit you were doing. You were not joking. You were seriously insecure about yourself and your relationship, and you thinking that I'm trying to come between you and what the fuck you got, which I don't want what the fuck you got, and I never have tried to come between what the fuck you got. I knew you didn't like me, which is why I stayed away from your motherfucking ass in the first place, because I was already told and briefed about the things that you were saying about me, but I kept it respectful because of my friend. That's why I kept the respect for in the first place. Did I ever speak to you when I saw you? No, because you were on messy shit then. But you never did get crunk until now. So no, I'll pass. So she was trying her best to get a reaction, and I wouldn't give it to her. So I would say, like, I didn't see her anymore until this week. I was going to the library to, I was going to the library for my little brother. He had a PowerPoint presentation. And since my computer doesn't have PowerPoint, which is crazy, just got PowerPoint Viewer. Windows 7 is a mess. We probably do got PowerPoint, but I just can't find it. But it said PowerPoint Viewer, so I couldn't make the PowerPoint on my computer, according to myself. So I went to the library to try to fix, try to add something to his slide. And from the moment I walked in, I saw the back of her head, that ugly ass blonde shit on her head. And I was sitting up here like, oh my God, this bitch is up in here. Good God, like, damn. So, I didn't say anything to her. I'm at the library. So, you know, I'm still in my sleeping attire. You know, I got on a damn wife beater and some, like, gray and red jogging pants on and some shoes that I haven't worn like a few years. Like, I was not on my A game at all. It was like 9:30 in the morning. So I'm up here at the library trying to get it in for my little brother so I can give his stuff, so I can go to school and give it to him. She's there. So I'm assigned a computer. I'm hoping I'm not assigned a computer next to her. So when I get my assignment for my computer, I realized that I'm not nowhere near her, but she can see me. So I'm sitting down at the computer, and here she is. Hey, Scotty. I don't say nothing. Hey, Scotty. I don't say nothing. Hey, Scotty. I don't say nothing again. Oh, so we not gonna speak now? We not gonna speak? I don't say nothing. I continue doing what I'm doing. And I'm saying to myself, I wish this bitch would leave me the fuck alone. But in an effort to not show out in public, and in an effort to keep my temper in check, I just decide to ignore her and just not make her relevant, because that's what the fuck she wants me to do. She wants me to make her relevant, and she's not relevant at all in my life. I don't even know this bitch name. I call this bitch Molly DeMay and Miss Senior Citizen, because she's just that, in my opinion, to me. I mean, she's pushing 40 and she's walking around here picking on 25-year-old boys about a man that, I mean, really, about a man that's younger than you and me. So get the fuck out of here, you know what I'm saying? So I didn't say anything to her then. We left the library at the same time. Like, after I got done fixing my little brother's PowerPoint, I left the library. I was getting ready to leave, and she was leaving at the same time I was, and then we had to drive the similar direction. So I was behind her, but at the end of the day, I still didn't say nothing to her. So she came in the store the next day. She came in again, and it was like at night. And she was like, "Hey, Scotty." I didn't say nothing to her. I didn't say anything to her. And then when she was getting ready to come on my line, my manager rushed over to a register and asked her to come in his line instead of mine. So I was like, "Thank God this bitch is not in my line." So as soon as she gets ready to leave, Scotty, like, calling my fucking name. And I'm like, you know, what is this bitch on? Like, why is she so pressed? And, you know, why is she so worried about moi? Like, moi ain't worried about you, bitch. So why are you so worried about me? Like, I don't even understand. I'm not thinking about you. You're not my cup of tea. I don't fuck with you. You're not my type of bitch. So with that being said, leave me alone. I don't want to have no problem with you. You really shouldn't want to have no problem with me. So leave me the fuck alone. You know what I'm saying? I don't agree with hitting females, but that bitch will make you want to hit her. You know what I'm saying? Like, I had fantasies about popping that bitch in her fucking face. But I have a mother and I have a sister. I have homegirls. If a man ever hit them, it's going down. So with that being said, I'm not gonna hit her. But she makes me want to take something and throw it at her. Like, if she come in my line, it makes me want to take this Dove shit and just throw it at her ass, because she getting on my fucking nerves. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's like she does this in public places so I can act a fool. And I'm not going to give her that satisfaction. She wants to be relevant, and she's not to me. So when she kept speaking to me, the manager was like, "You see the woman speaking?" I said, "I'm not making anyone relevant, so who's speaking to me?" And he was like, "She's speaking to you." I said, "Is it Casper? Because I don't see anybody. I don't see anyone, so I don't know what you're talking about." And she was like, "Really? Really? You want to play it like that? Really?" And I'm sitting up here like, "Bitch, you just tried me 2 weeks ago. Why are you trying to speak to me? We are not cool. We were never cool. I don't like you. I never have. Why? Based on the things that my best friend told me that you said. And I know that my best friend won't lie about some bullshit that a bitch said about me. So with that being said, you've never been my cup of tea, and I've never been your biggest fan, period. So with that being said, I don't want to have shit to do with you. Leave me alone. And keep it moving. If you see me at work, don't say nothing to me. If somebody else is having a register, go in a register. Don't come in mine. If you have to come in my register, don't talk to me. Unless it's about 225 is your total, 135 is your change, or something like that. Other than that, you don't need to be talking to me, because I don't fuck with you. I don't like you. I don't want nothing to do with you. So with that being said, y'all, it's like this bitch is just obsessed. Because you just tried to front on me in front of all these people trying to talk greasy and shit, knowing that I couldn't get up in your ass the way I wanted to because I was at work. But now you want to try me every time you see me in public, knowing that if I get crunk with you in public, because I am a man, despite what my preference is, I'm still a man at the end of the day, and you still a bitch. So with that being said, if I'm getting crunk with you and going crazy with you, or even if I walk in a direction where it looks like I'm going to charge you, I'm going to jail because I'm a man. So I believe she's trying to provoke me into hitting her. And I don't hit females. You know, I used to be the type of nigga back in the day when I was young, growing up, like, I wouldn't give a fuck if you was a boy or girl. If you hit me, I'm going to hit you back. That's when I was in middle school. But as I got older or whatever in high school and, you know, being a grown-ass man, I just don't agree with hitting women. I just don't. Like, I will choke one if they walk up on me, but I'm not going to hit a female. I would choke you to restrain you. And choking is no better, but bitch, don't walk up on me. Get the fuck out my face. If I'm telling you to get the fuck out my face, don't come in my face. If you come in my face, I'm gonna throw something at you. Bottom line, like, people used to get up on K. Michelle throwing candles. I threw one before. Or hitting people with flowers. You gotta understand, I'm skinny as fuck. 9 times out of 10, you weigh more than me. So I'm gonna do whatever I possibly can to get you out my face. So with that being said, y'all, what do y'all think about this situation? Like, this is like the follow-up to it. Like, this bitch is very obsessed with me. I don't know why. I'm not really here for her, and I'm not really thinking about her. But just leave your comments below, and I will talk to y'all later. And I'm out of here, y'all. Peace.